the best team in the AFC in the regular season. We won two games in the playoffs against two good football teams. Best team in the postseason. And that's what this team is. And I know that because I've been with them every day. And I'm proud of this team.
1 week and a day before the Super Bowl, the Patriots head coach trying to dial back the heat on his team. The league confirming several footballs used in New England's playoff win over the Colts were illegal. Now the founding editor of ESPN's magazine and a former VP there calling for the Patriots to be banned from the Super Bowl. How would that go down? Dan Kaplan is here. He is the NFL writer for the Sports Business Journal. Before we get to that, what about that press conference, Dan?
Well, I thought you were going to superimpose a scientist smock on Coach Belichick. He talked a lot about air pressure and scientific testing that the Patriots had conducted in the last few days. That's a big takeaway from that press conference is that they did their own test on the footballs and claimed that potentially the weather, the atmosphere may have been behind why the balls lost the air pressure.
Do you think Belichick's and Brady's testimony credible?
Well, I mean, unfortunately, this is a team that skirted the rules before. If this were another team that had balls that were under the limit, I don't think we'd be seeing this kind of reaction. If this were the Cleveland Browns, who are currently the subject of an NFL investigation into illegal activity during a game, you wouldn't see this kind of attention. It's because it's the Patriots, and it's because, obviously, it's the NFL.
All right, so now you have ESPN's editor, the magazine editor, saying, hey, the Patriots should not be allowed to play in the Super Bowl. Could that even happen at this point?
No, I mean, that's not going to happen. First of all, if you look at the penalty the NFL has for this kind of activity, it's not even loss of draft picks. I mean, clearly they could go beyond what's laid out, but it's a financial penalty. This is a story that gets a lot of eyeballs, a lot of attention. If you say something dramatic like that, you're going to get attention. But we don't really know at this point what happened with those balls. The NFL is still conducting its investigation. Perhaps they should bring on a physicist to do some tests. They haven't done that so far. But clearly, this is a story that people like, and it has legs.
Yeah, it has legs. The NFL, listen, they want the focus to be on the game, on the big game. So if the NFL does not get to the bottom of this, press and fans will keep talking about it.
Absolutely.
If NFL does get to the bottom of this, the press and fans will keep talking about it. So what's going to happen?
Well, I suspect sometime in February we'll finally hear from the NFL the results of their investigation. I wouldn't expect that to be in time for next week at the Super Bowl, but it's going to be the dominant topic of Media Day, of the commissioner's press conference on Friday, of probably the union press conference on Thursday. This is all anyone will want to talk about. I guess the one benefit is usually Super Bowl hype is very uninteresting. It's pretty interesting this year.
Yeah, but is this going to play on the psyche of the players?
I think for the Patriots, it will be the classic bulletin board material. I would imagine Coach Belichick will use it to motivate his players, to say it's this us against the world. It's the classic motivational technique in football, and I imagine the Patriots will try to use it to their advantage.
So then how do the Seahawks use it to their advantage?
It's interesting. You've noticed everyone's piled on to this story but Seattle. Seattle does not want to get involved with this story. They don't want to be seen quoted as saying the Patriots cheat because it's bulletin board material. It's probably somewhat difficult for them to focus because everyone's asking them about it. They are doing a good job, though, of not taking the bait.
Well, we shall see how this next week plays out, and I'm sure we'll talk to you again, Dan Kaplan.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you very much. Absolutely.